Lovely to see you.
Lovely to see you
Are
too.
you in London?
I am.
Excellent. I
Are you?
am, I'm afraid, yes, but we're not allowed to see you too close. I know you're doing some Q&As around my area tonight. Do you like doing that selling your film around the world? Do you like coming to here and speaking to English audiences?
Yes, of course.
What does that give you
Always.
as a filmmaker to actually speak to the audience who've just seen the film?
You fill the room, you feel it gives you feedback. And it's not only about this film. I'm not coming to have feedback on this film. I'm really happy to talk about cinema with cinema goers. I could do Q&As for films that are not mine. It's just also something that I enjoy. I really love talking about cinema.
Yeah, let's do that. Let's arrange that one day. A little Celine Sciamma, a little season of Sciamma picks. If we could do a great season of just your own films, talking about your own cinema. But this one is particularly beautiful, Celine, and haunting. Was it something that you wanted a change of pace from Portrait of a Lady on Fire, which was, a costume drama, had sort of bigger production values? Was this like, I just want to get back to kind of simple.
Well, I had this idea while I was writing Portrait of a Lady on Fire, so now 4 or 5 years ago. So I've been living with this idea as a warm promise. And I was like, whatever happens with Portrait of a Lady on Fire, I land there. So it wasn't like a strategy that, it was planned this way, that this would be my next film that I wanted to do, whatever happens, and that it would be some form of shelter.
So
In a
when you say you
way,
had the idea when you were making Portrait, what was the idea?
the idea was an image, and this image was is it's basically the film. It's two little girls in the woods. They're building a tree house, and my understanding of that image was that one was obviously the mother and one was obviously the daughter, which is something that I can't explain, but that I feel grateful that I was handed by, I don't know, a dream,
The
a
muse.
daydreaming. Yeah.
I wondered if it was similar because, in Portrait, of course, there's a fire on, and I don't know if it came. Was it that night that it came for you when you're looking at the bonfire and you're seeing these sticks together?
No, because I really had the idea while I was writing
Ooh.
portraits. So it was just two screenwriting ideas competing in my brain,
What do you
which
do
doesn't happen.
when you have that? Because it doesn't happen very often. I know it's
No.
difficult to write a script. Do you think I'm going to finish Portrait and then I must write this other idea down and put it in my drawer and be careful?
Exactly. And it was just something that I kept dreaming about because when I had this image and popped up into my mind, then the whole script unrolled actually. It was quite easy to mentally write. And I was
Really?
tempted to go for it. Yeah, it was really easy. I don't know why. Maybe because.
Because you say it's easy, but when you're writing it, you're going to say, well, I've got to make this visual. I've got to make this happen. I've got two children. It's going to be quite confusing for people. They're going to say, what's going on? She's lost
Of
her mind.
course. Yeah, that's when you actually write it. But when you have an idea and you just freely start to unroll it in your mind, and you're like, okay, so they would meet. Oh, okay, so how would they meet? Oh, and then there would be the grandmother. Oh, but maybe they would. So would they share the same mother and we could have a new image of a family? It's just like that. That's what I call easy. Then you have to make those ideas happen. But this thing when you start, we all know how to write. This thing. You could
Yeah.
we could do it right away with a pitch that we would invent together, and suddenly things would happen very
Oh,
fast.
please God, and we'd make the film. That'd be great. That'd be nice and easy, Celine. It's been a long time I wanted to make a scenario with you. What's personal about this to you? Did you have a sister? I don't know your family, but did you have a grandmother? So, well, we've all had grandmothers and grandparents and parents.
Yes,
That's what
yes.
connects. But did you have a particular sister? Do you have a jumelle, a twin?
No, not at all. I mean, I have a sister and a brother, and I'm the eldest, so I have a great experience of siblings, and I define myself as an elder sister, in
Yeah,
a way.
it's a responsibility.
Yeah, and a privilege and also responsibility. But thank God they were there, and still are. Yeah, no, this is a very personal film regarding the fact that it's shot in my hometown, for instance. Water Lilies was also shot in the same town. And actually, the house of Marion, the brick house, is exactly the same neighborhood as Adele and Elle's character in What a Lily is, and it's kind of the same house. No one
and
has
which
noticed
town is
it so
that?
far.
Maybe remind me.
It's Cergy-Pontoise. It's a new town, 30 kilometers from Paris, and it's a town that was born in the 70s, as I was. And so it's a very specific town. I grew up in a town that was not very much older than I was. No old stones. And this pyramid.
That's a real pyramid.
That's a real pyramid.
That's on the lake in Cergy-Pontoise.
Exactly.
And everyone knows it.
Yes. So this is all obviously personal. And but the most personal thing in the film, and actually it was the first time, is basically the character of the grandmother, which is based on my own grandmother. And it's the first time that I was actually working around the ghost. And, you know, I'm the costume designer of the film, and some of the costumes are the actual clothing of my grandmother. She had that handicap. This is her own cane. So it's, and even this, you know, the film is studio shot. So that this house is built from scratch.
Oh,
and
wow.
It's designed from a fusion of both my grandmother's interiors. The kitchen is my Italian grandmother, and the rest of the flat. It's my French grandmother, and
they had a flat like this with the hidden wall, the secret
exactly.
cupboard.
Yeah, yeah,
I love
yeah.
that detail. That's such a, you know, my grandmother had that, and you push one. It was in wood, not in wallpaper, but in wood.
You can't invent such a detail.
And
yeah,
I just used to like pressing the thing. So that's why you're the costumier, because I saw that, the credit. I said, oh, she's done the costumes now. I mean, yeah. I know you've done those before, but this was because you had actual artifacts from your grandmother, from your family, including this walking stick and
exactly. But it's not taking too much space in the film, because we have very, very few background or backstory about that family. I really wanted everyone to feel that this was a personal space for them. And you know, I'm really happy that you like that cupboard. And
you want to know my other favorite detail?
Yeah,
is when she eats the what we call them Watsits, when she has the little apéro snack and she eats it like that.
Yeah,
that's,
yeah.
That was.
I told her you have to eat it like a little squirrel.
Well, she does, and then the mum giving it to the mum. I thought those were gorgeous details, and I like that in you, because I think there's sort of new exploratory details coming into your work that I like. It's always been, as you know, a big fan, but those seem to be very real. It was nice to return to child, because Tomboy was I suppose another childhood revisiting, but this one felt, I don't know, felt because it was so ghostly and dreamlike, it felt that you could play more with it. And so tell me about these two girls. How do you find two girls? That's your first thing. You've got to find some twins.
Well, you know, I wasn't looking for really twins. I was looking for sisters. That was the idea. I wanted to do a sisters so that it would be comfortable for them to work together, so that to work with one family. And also because that was my personal question within the film. Actually, my question was, if I met my mother at 8, would she be my sister? She would be my sister. She wouldn't be my mother.
Good question.
Or would she be my friend? You know, or would we fall in love? You know, there's a lot of questions you could ask yourself if you start to really look at it. And so I said, okay, I'm going to embody this idea. And because it's also about troubling genealogy, you know, it's about bringing down some hierarchy and looking, the mother and the daughter looking at each other with equality.
What do you think you got from your grandmother?
So much. I mean, I had the luck to know both my grandmother as an adult, because my maternal grandmother, she passed away when I did Tomboy, so you know, and she was 103 years old.
So I've benefited.
Yeah, I've benefited from everything: her wisdom, her sadness, her vision of the world, her limits, everything.
In France, in England, if you're 100, you know, I don't know if you know this, you get a postcard, carte postale, from the Queen, congratulating you on being 100. Everyone who gets this.
She looked a lot like, she looks a lot like the Queen. So she looked a lot like the Queen.
But in France, you don't get anything from Mitterrand
or
something. I don't
think so. I don't know, no. Most of the things, that's my big luck in my life.
Yeah,
because,
me
and
too.
Then my other grandmother, she passed away this year.
Ah, me too, just before COVID.
I'm 43. And I've been in the company of these women. And so I got to ask the questions. I got to have the conversation as an adult. And that's why I'm able to do this film.
Yes, also. And also when you lose a grandmother this late on in your life, 43, I was old, 50, there's a balance that changes now in the family. But for so long, you've had these matriarchs, you know, that's so it's different for your mother, and then it's different for you and your sisters. There's a balance that kind of comes out. Maybe you're working, that's what you're working out on screen. That's why I felt so touched by this film.
Maybe, yes. I mean, the film was done before, but now it's happening in life. Yeah. So I'm going to see, how it's troubling.
Yeah. It's troubling and lovely at the same time. What's strange about the film is that it's
troubling
haunting.
Is lovely. Yeah. Troubling is a very positive quality for me.
Yeah.
Troubling is always being in trouble, you know, that kind of trouble.
I think you're right. Actually, now I think about it, because girlhood was troubling, but beautiful. Same as Tomboy and same as Portrait. Yeah, absolutely. You're right.
Oh, thank you.
Well done, Celine. where does it sit for you in your... I know you don't... Maybe you don't consciously say, right, this is how I work, this is what I'm going to do, but your message seems to be pretty clear throughout all the films. Mm-hmm. You seem to have, you know, women at their forefront, and you tell these stories in this way, the connections, the love, the strength of bond between women. Is that just because that's what you're interested in? Is that what comes to you? Or is it something that you say, right, you know, I want to do a bank job heist movie, but I'm not going to do it unless I do it with women or something. It just what comes out.
No, I don't think like that. I'm just very lucky that I'm interested in this, because there's a lot to explore, because it has been despised and ignored. So I'm not doing this as a reparation. But of course, it's reparation also, because we've been missing images, we've been missing insight, we've been missing charisma, we've been missing a lot of things. So I don't. So it's. I mean, it's pretty clear that that impact, that impulse is also linked to some kind of missing image. But it's vital. It's organic. It's not something that I. Plan. I just live my life.
you said you could talk about cinema all day, and I said we could talk about your films all day. But is there a, as you say, it's been missing, and there isn't really anyone doing the things you do. But is there a cinematic career that you use as inspiration? Is there a filmmaker that you particularly take some ideas from or some feelings from?
Well, for this film, because it's been done, huh? it's also been erased. For this film, I really. During lockdown, I watched a lot of films from the pioneers of cinema, and a lot of those pioneers were women. So I watched films by Alice Guy Blacher, Germaine Dulac, Mabel Normand.
Mm.
She invented Chaplin, you know?
Yes, she did.
And, you know, I really thought about this for Petite Maman. I was like, because they invented magic realism. They invented fiction at cinema. They invented magic in the cut. They invented fiction. The Brother Lumière, they invented documentary, right?
Yeah.
And so I was really thinking about these women. I was like, oh, I'm going to do the film with exactly the same tool as they have. Studio shoot, editing, everything down in front of the camera. Even like the monster, the panther, it's human. Mm-hmm. Everything is made. And so I was like, oh, yeah, I'm going to have exactly the same tools as they have. This is like the child of the cinema.
Mm. You say studio shoot, but surely there's a wonderful scene with all the, I don't know how you do it, all the leaves blowing at the same time. I don't know if it's CGI or you just waited for the moment for all the leaves. And
no CGI. No, you just hope for the wind. And you're like, and when it happens, you just do that in front of your small screen so that it looks like you're doing it. But you know.
You're conducting the winds like King Lear.
Sometimes you feel like you're conducting. When this happens... It happens all the time. Yeah. I mean, that something happens like weather-wise, and you feel I just always try to take it as really good news and like, wow.
Oh, it's beautiful scenes.
Collaboration with the elements.
I was like, you know, I like this girl. She does a lot of good stuff. I've been following her career, and now she can command the leaves to even move. This is skills I'm thinking here.
But we brought a lot of leaves in this forest because it was really green. So a lot of the leaves that are on the floor... and even hanging in the trees, there are leaves from another fall.
Spare leaves. Okay, I didn't know.
Yeah, so you can also intervene on the. I love that. I love to do intervention on in the exterior. You know, paint a wall. You know, cheat like that.
Yes.
It's really nice.
Tell me about the music again, because you have a key song that they said, what is that, the music of the future? And I think it's even called La Musique de l'Avenir,
yeah.
the song. By Para One, who you worked with on Portrait
all
of
the
a
films.
Lady. All of
yeah.
them, okay.
Yeah.
Tell
yeah.
me about that continued portrait and how you said to them, I want a song that is La Musique de l'Avenir. or du futur, je pense du futur.
Yeah, it was like a very simple. We have a strong connection with Parawan. Is one person, so there is a one is
Ah, one, of course.
any yeah any. We were at film school together. He's a director, and we have a strong connection around friendship and melodies around friendship and for friendship, childhood, sorry, and friendship also, but childhood. And so this was the perfect task for him. Really, like I was now. This is we're gonna do it. We're gonna write this. Like ending credit of a cartoon from the 80s that could have existed with the high level of experimentation and synthetic sounds, and also just being generous. And I also want a child choir. You know, we were going all the way with it. And he actually said, "Well, you should write lyrics. It should be a song." And so I got to write lyrics for the first
This
time,
is
and
your
I was
first lyrics. I thought that. What is the lyric? I was trying to hear it.
It says voices of kids will sing because the song is in the future tense because it will always be the song of the future. Voices of kids will sing new dreams,
En français?
dreams, des voix d'enfants chanteront de nouveaux rêves, and the dream, le rêve d'être enfant avec toi, the dream of being a child
Oh,
with
with
you.
you. And the same choir sings it, the same voices that sang I can't remember the name of the of that gorgeous song by the fire.
No. This was a choir of women in Portrait of a Lady on Fire, and this is the choir of children.
It is a children's
Yeah,
choir from
yeah,
Sergi
yeah.
Pontoise.
No, from the suburbs of Paris, but it's a choir, and I really wanted to have collaboration with kid artists, you know.
It's beautiful. It's a beautiful song. I hope we can get to
Thank
play
you.
it. I hope we can find it. I couldn't. I Shazam did not have it when I first.
It's on Spotify.
It's
It's on
already there.
every. It's
Good.
already, yeah.
Was
You
my
can listen.
next. That was my next port of call. So what happens to you now, Céline? I mean, because Petite Maman was. Oh, you've done the other one. I wanted to ask you about was Paris 13, that you worked on with Jacques Audiard, as you were a co-scenario a screenwriter on that one.
Yeah, I was the first screenwriter on the project 5 years ago.
Right.
It was before Portrait and before the Sister Brothers for Jacques.
Ah.
And I was the first one to take a pass at Tomini's adaptation. And the project is out now. It's
Yes.
really it feels like it has transformed, evolved a lot.
You didn't want to direct it?
Oh no, I was writing it for him.
Okay.
He asked me. He asked me to write. And you know what? When I write for other people, I never want to direct it. I'm really happy that
Well, it's a beautiful film as well, so they all fine.
Yeah.
Hey, tell me just quickly before you go, the first film you saw in the cinema.
Brisby and the Secret of Nim by Don Bluth.
Don Bluth, yeah, a cartoon, beautiful film. Yeah. Where was
Yeah.
that? In Sergi Pontoise.
No, it was in Paris. It was the first time that I went in Paris. I think it was also the first time that I actually ate a burger. And I remember I got into the room, I think it was four. I got into the room and the film was had already started. So the first time I got in the cinema, the film had started. It was very dark. And I remember there was the end of a very old mouse on screen like that. And you can find it on YouTube, the end of this very old. So that's my first image. And I had gums, I had two gums in my hand. They were melting because I was holding them so strong. I remember everything about it. I
Amazing.
really remember
You really
everything
do. Do you
about
know
it.
which cinema?
I don't, I think it was in the Latin Quarter, maybe Opera, maybe Champs-Élysées. You know, when you come from the suburb, you also, the cinema you go to, they are on the train, you
Yeah.
know. So I used to hang out a lot in Champs-Élysées, which is fucked up. No, not fucked up. It's the wouldn't happen to me anymore.
No.
So it might be in one of these places.
Yeah,
Yep.
grand cinema. I don't know. A
Yeah.
great Don Bluth as well. A great animator. I'm glad you remember it. Thank you for sharing it with me. I could talk to you, as I say, all day. I wish I was
Me
doing the Q
too.
and A's with you, but it's always lovely to see you. And à la prochaine.
À la prochaine. Salut.
Bye. Salut, Céline.
Bye.
Ciao.